Afghanistan's history is very closely tied up to history of Pakistan, or what was then India. But this, the border adjoining the border with Afghanistan is, you know, if you know the history of that, of the Pashtun people, because they're roughly half the population of Afghanistan is Pashtun. Double that, the number of Pashtuns live in Pakistan. And along the Afghan border, both sides are Pashtun tribes. So if you know the history, anyone who knew the history knew this would happen. So people like me who, you know, who know the history, and I did a travel book also of this, of our side of the Pashtun areas, Pashtun tribes, we knew this would happen. We knew that eventually there would not be a military solution, because the people do not accept foreigners. They have resisted foreigners, especially if they are not Muslims. And the Pashtun tribes might fight each other, but when a foreigner comes, they get together. And then the second characteristic of a Pashtun is that they seek revenge. If there's someone is killed in their house, they will seek revenge. And to seek revenge, they will join the militants. So on this side of the border, exactly the same thing happened when we decided to become an ally of the U.S. Because the Taliban were Pashtun, sympathies for Taliban, not because of the religious ideology, but because of the Pashtun nationalism, on our side of the border, we had for the first time the Pakistani Taliban. And they called us collaborators and started attacking us, which is the TTP. The Pakistani Taliban. Exactly the same thing happened on the other side. The more collateral damage, the more drone attacks or aerial bombing, the more night raids where people were humiliated or killed, the more the militant ranks swelled. So the Taliban movement grew over a period of time. And so we, by 2008, I went to the US. I addressed the think tanks. I met Joe Biden as a senator. I met John Kerry as a senator. And I explained to them. But then I realized that they were clueless. The American public had no idea what was going on in Afghanistan. Hence, they are completely taken by surprise. They thought they had built a democratic government, that there was some, they had liberated their women. You know, people in the US thought like that. And there were so few American casualties. So Afghanistan was, you know, something which was not in their minds. So when this suddenly happened, they had been all taken by surprise. And therefore, you see this in Senate, the sort of questions being asked. They are so, they had no idea that this was happening. But believe me, in Pakistan, people who knew Afghanistan's history, Army Chief in 2010, General Kiani, went to meet President Obama. He explained to them that there will not be a military solution, that the moment you lead, the Afghan army will collapse. He told them that, look, you will leave a mess there, and we in Pakistan will suffer the consequences. But he, again, they had no idea. You see, it was this awful, arrogant, imperialistic attitude of the Americans under George Bush when he said, either you're with us or against us. You know, after 9/11, this amazingly ridiculous statement, if you do not support our policies, you're against us. So therefore, if I did not agree with this military solution in Afghanistan, then I was pro-Taliban. I'm anti-military solutions. I do not believe that the way to solve world's problems are using military means. I was against the Iraq war. If there's an objective analysis done about what has happened in Iraq, I even objected to my own country using military means, for instance, in East Pakistan, when we used military, you know, to resolve the issue. I do not believe in military solutions. But in this case, I knew the subject much better than anyone in the U.S. understood. So therefore, it was this amazing thing that, you know, if you criticize the U.S. policies, you were anti-American and you were pro-Taliban.